Now is frozen. This is an angle of this attack that we have not seen before. At the top of the building on your left, out of the left, will come the building. And watch how the aircraft penetrates the building. Go ahead. Completely in one side and out the other.
It just disappeared. It disappeared like a bad special effect. It disappeared right into the building. I've seen it 6-7 times now. It's still incomprehensible what is actually happening there. You're right. As a journalist, you have to take yourself away from it, and I'm still not there yet. And the more and more I see it, and as time goes by,
the modern technology enables us to see horror just as we are able to see sport in a variety of different speeds or at a variety of different speeds. And I think you now have a better appreciation than we have had up until now, for which we thank you, Evan, because we see exactly how determined somebody was to do this horrible damage, taking a plane so powerfully and so fast in one side of the building. Tell me more what it's been like for you today as working the street.
It's numbing. It's like being in the fourth dimension. It's like we're not even it's not even New York City where it's happening. Nothing is normal. People are just walking in a daze up and down the streets. Nobody knows where to go. I just feel kind of this nervous, anxious buzz and still unfathomable.
Trinity Church, one of the oldest, I think the oldest Episcopal church, certainly in this part of the world, certainly the oldest in the city, on the edge of Wall Street there. Was it being used? Did people come to it for any subsequent occasion?
We were only shooting a kind of a teleconference up in the fourth floor TV studio there. And we were all sitting in the studio about an hour before our airtime, and there was the lights went out for a second, they flickered. And we kind of joked with the studio guys that they had just put in a new studio and said, hey, you guys better watch out for that. That's not normal. Mm. And then within 10 seconds, people came running in and said that the Trade Center had been hit. They tried to call a production meeting and ask people to stay in the building, and people were just kind of fleeing. And I grabbed my still camera and was going to run out, not really heeding what anybody was saying there, knowing what was happening outside and feeling the need to be there. And one of the guys came out of the studio with a camera and was putting a tape in it, and I just grabbed it and ran.
And we saw the shadow of you running across the street. What was you afraid of, principally, as you were running?
I was afraid that I was going to be rained upon by whatever was coming off the building. So I knew that I had a few seconds to get basically an establishing shot, and then I had to look out for myself. And I ran. I was on the southeast corner of the plaza. I'm not sure exactly what building is there. And I just went around the corner a little south on Church and just got underneath the car and pointed the camera up into the sky and stayed there for a while, and then came out after a few minutes when the debris stopped raining so heavily. And I went around the corner and was pulled under an overhang by a couple of Port Authority police, to whom I immediately mentioned what I had shot. And they just grabbed me and whisked me down into the Port Authority police headquarters. And we were leaving there to go back to Trinity Church to make a dub of the tape, when suddenly the Tower 2, the top, collapsed. And I just looked up and saw from basically two blocks away this reverse mushroom cloud coming down at me.
I know, I said earlier, this looks like a banana suddenly being peeled. It's extraordinary.
I've seen shots of the collapse from far away, and I just can't believe that I was actually there and walked away. I mean, I had to dive underneath. I ran backwards with the camera just pointed behind me, away from the scene, and saw that, you know, have heard about clouds enveloping people and oxygen being depleted, and I just dove under the biggest emergency response vehicle that I could see, stayed there for about 30 seconds, saw nothing but pitch black. I started having difficulty breathing. I thought my oxygen was starting to dwindle, and there was a moment when I said, well, this might be it. And my only chance is to get out and start walking north.
Well, we're very grateful to you, very grateful you're okay, and
thank you.
And that you took these photographs and that you shared them with the public. They're very dramatic. I needn't tell you that, but I'm very grateful to you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Nice to see you. Evan Fairbank. He's a freelance photographer who was working in Trinity Church today on the edge of Wall Street today when he and his colleagues on a production shoot in a church saw these two extraordinary scenes directly from a different angle, because we have seen it so many times, but this is the most dramatic angle we have seen this plane flying at the top of that building. It's quite extraordinary. I want to go to Washington very briefly, because we said the president was on his way, we believe, to Washington from Nebraska.